Hello my dear children, welcome to my channel Sudhir Sir Chemistry. But now we are going to discuss, till now we discussed one is a inner orbital complex, other one is the outer orbital complex. And now we are going to discuss one more example. See here, a very good example. This is a Ni Cl4 and with a minus of 2 charge. Just now I told you X is the halogen, O is the oxygen, S is the sulfur. And they all treat together, that will make what with a weak field ligand. What they make? Weak field ligand. And even I mentioned with a CO carbon monoxide is a, see, other than these three, all are the strong field, but in that case CO is the most strong field ligand according to our spectrochemical series. Now see here, in this Ni, but a Ni ki atomic number, if you write, it is equal to 28. That means configuration should be written as a AR argon 18, beta 18 plus 2 20, 20 plus 8 28. This is the configuration we are writing for Ni. Now what is the oxidation number of Ni? See, Ni ki oxidation number means X plus. How many chlorine we have, beta 4. And do you know oxidation number of all the halogens is a minus 4 equal to charge? Minus 2. Sir, it become X minus 4 equal to minus 2. Minus 4 become plus 4. Plus 4 minus 2 become plus 2. So my Ni nickel will have the valency plus 2 beta. As it has a valency plus 2, we can say it loses 2 electrons from the valence shell. So 4s0 and 3d8. Beta, we can write in the increasing order 3d8, 4s0, 4p0. Now in D we are having 5 degenerate orbitals beta. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. Beta, S orbital only 1 is there. And P orbital we are having 3 are there. Now one more part. Beta, Cl is a halogen. Can you tell me this halogen is a WFL or SFL? Sir, obviously it is a WFL. See, halogen is a WFL. Beta, if it is a WFL means I should say, sir, no pairing of electrons. What beta? No pairing of electrons. Sir, here no pairing of electron means I should leave as it is. So it indicates 2 unpaired. Obviously my N is equal to 2. Magnetic moment is equal to under root of N into N plus 2 beta. 2 under root of N into N plus 2. 2 plus 2 4. 4 into 2 8. So root 8. Beta, root 9 means 3. Root 8 means 2 point something Bohr's magneton. Number of unpaired is there. Obviously the nature is the paramagnetic in nature. Magnetic moment 2 point something. Paramagnetic in nature. And how many ligands are there? 4. So we want 4 vacant orbital. 1 chlorine can donate its 1 pair to the 1st, 2nd, 3rd and 4th. And this is the configuration where we are getting sp3. That means it is the tetrahedral complex. Is it clear, beta? Chalo, one more example I will discuss with you. Just take a screenshot of this one. One more very good example. Second one is private. This one Ni carbon monoxide CO taken 4 times and no charge present outside it. Please, beta, everyone try this complex compound. Get the hybridization of central metal atom. Find out its magnetic moment. And see whether it is an inner orbital complex or outer orbital complex. But I didn't want anything here because no d orbital involved, neither inner orbital nor the outer orbital involved. So I didn't want anything. Only I want to mention sp3 hybridization tetrahedral geometry. But in this case, if inner d orbital involved, you can say inner orbital complex. Outer orbital will involve, you should say outer orbital complex. If nothing is involved, you should say it is a tetrahedral or other than that any complexes. Please try it and get the screenshot of this one. So as the NCERT is mentioning, beta, it is a sp3 tetrahedral, no inner orbital involved, so you should call it as a high spin complex. You should call it as a what? High spin complex. But this is the complex where Ni is there and CO taken 4 times is there. Central metal atom Ni, CO is a strong field ligand, even it is the most strong field ligand according to our spectrochemical series, right? So we can say, beta, Ni, its atomic number 28, if it is 28, I should mention it as a AR argon. Beta 18 plus 2, 20. 20 plus 8, 28. What is the oxidation number of NSL? 0. Ha beta? CO is a molecule, you know. It is a molecule. So molecule oxidation number 0, Ni oxidation number 0. So write down as it is now. In increasing order, it is a 3D8. It is a 4S2. And then if you require, you can write 4P0 and 4D0 and 1. But a 3D8 means make the 5 degenerate boxes for 3D. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. This is the S orbital. And this one is the P orbital. Now how many are there, beta? 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Beta S is having 2. And we know that CO is a SFL, strong field ligand. Sir, pairing of electron takes place. But as the pairing of electrons takes place, means your 3D which is given there can be write in this way. This 2 as it is. But these 2 as it is. These 2 as it is. This will come inside. It is as it is. Means already 3D 8 over. But the 2 electron which is present in the 4S, it will also come inside. And 3D 8 become 3D 10. 4S 2 become 4S 0. And 4P will be as it is, like a 4P 0. But how many ligand we have? Sir, 4 ligand we have. And now each ligand will donate its lone pair to the vacant orbital. 1, 2, 3, 4. Its hybridization is beta sp3. That means geometry is a tetrahedral. But a tetrahedral geometry, again we can say, sir, no unpaired electron. So it is a diamagnetic in nature. But a unpaired electron 0, diamagnetic means magnetic moment also 0. And you can see beta here, still inside no orbital involved, only outside. So again we can say this will be called as a what? High spin complex. So it is a one more example we did place on the Ni. First one beta, Ni with Cl4. So Cl is a weak field ligand. Beta now Ni with a CO taken 4 time. Even CO is a strong field ligand in both the complexes. Did you saw beta? Central atom will have sp3 hybridization. Either it is a sp3 or dsp2 base. It is only based on the ligand present over it. Right? Chalo, one more third one I will give based on the Ni. Till that time, take a screenshot of this one.